Hello guys, and today I'm going to show you why I'm calling this a falsely advertised product and not a fake product. Its name is Unlexoon, but actually it's not a DC adapter. It's an AC converter. I bought it because I wanted to buy a step-down transformer from 240 volts that we use in Kenya to 120 volts. So that you can use American electronics in this country. So, I don't know why they chose to use the same box for two different products. Over here it's a DC adapter, the specifications, but over here it's an AC converter. And the output it says is 200 to 500 watts. But when I bought it, I was told that this unit is 300 watts right there, 300 watts unit. So this is what came out of the box. It's an AC step down transformer from 240 to 120, because in Kenya we use 240 volts AC. Like always, it's made in China. So when I tested this product, the amplifier that I was using, the Onkyo amplifier, it just switched off on its own. And I'm guessing it had a problem to do with this product over here. So before I continue with this, let me show you my previous transformer. This is the transformer that I normally use. It's also a step-down transformer. This, even if it's written 220 volts, it usually converts from 240 volts to 120 volts. So it says, for your safety, always connect the electronic appliance you are using into the 110 volt socket before plugging the cord into the wall. So basically, just plug in whatever you want to plug in here, maybe your TV or hi-fi, then you take the other end and put it in your socket. And it still works even with this huge dent over here. This is a 200 watts step down transformer, and that's the output port. So this transformer was 200 watts and it worked perfectly with that AV receiver I was repairing, but I wanted it to work with a much smaller item but of higher amperage. So I went and bought this one, 300 watts, but it didn't work. 300 watts does not work, but 200 watts worked perfectly. So this means this is a falsely advertised product. So the first thing I did was open it, not to check inside, but to actually put super glue on this output port. It was coming off. So let me open it up for you so that you can see the rest. Let me cut that video real quick so that you can show you something. This is my TV. It works with 110 to 240 volts. So I'm plugging in my TV to 240 volts. There, it's working. So let me try the other 110 volts transformer. So now I'm going to plug in my 120 volts transformer. Plug it in like that, and then plug into the power. It's also working. So I'll take my multimeter real quick and prove to you that the voltage is 120. So I have a small gap over here. Yeah, it's actually 118 volts. So for these small devices like TV and radio, this transformer will work fine. But for bigger items, it won't work. It's falsely advertised. This is not 300 watts. And in the future, I'm going to do a video where I test the current moving through the cables. So I need my clamp-on meter for that. I don't have that right now. So in future video, I'll do that video and prove to you how many watts this transformer is. So if you check inside, this looks like a recycled product. Don't have anything against recycled product as long as they work and work as they are advertised. There's no way this is a 300 watts transformer. The core seems rusted. You have flimsy wires over here to the output. Looks like somebody did the rewiring and just stuck this iron core inside. You can look at that. I don't know what they are using to laminate the core. Maybe some kind of glue. There's absolutely no fuse inside here. So I was quite disappointed with this product. There's no mechanism of fixing this transformer inside there. It just sits there on its own. So I'm saying this is a falsely advertised product, but not a fake product, because it advertises to be 300 watts, but it actually didn't work with 190 watts AV receiver that I will link the video to in the video description below. If it was a fake product, for example, it would have the logo Lucky Sky, for example, over here. It will have all this branding of a good product on the product itself, even the branding, but it wouldn't work because it's falsely advertised. So it doesn't mean that fake products don't work, they actually work. What bothers me are the falsely advertised products. This problem also occurs in solar panels. Somebody can advertise a solar panel to be 100 watts and maybe it's just only maybe 24 watts or 28 watts. So always buy from reputable guys, but you never know. I'm the electronics guy and I was caught up in this lie. So thanks for watching. So if you're asking if I'm going to return this, no, I'm not going to return it to the shop. I'm just going to use it. It will work. It's just don't going to work with bigger products. A small radio perhaps might work. Maybe I'm not sure if a TV will work, but small radios will surely work. But not appliances that produce heat like kettles or iron boxes. But a small radio or maybe a phone charger will work. So thanks for watching and goodbye. So before I go, let me test one more thing, my decoder. So my decoder is rated at 170 volts to 240 volts. I don't expect it to work on this transformer, but let's try. It's actually come on. Let me see if it loads. Yeah, it's loading. I didn't expect that, but it works.